Need some coins for golden tickets? Head on over to rockbottomcoins.com for the safest and cheapest coins anywhere. Use code ZERK at checkout for a 10% discount on your order. The whole thing wobbing. What is going on, guys? It is Xerxy coming at you today with another YouTube video, and today we have the new Ultimate Legends, Franco Harris, and also Ronnie Frickin' Lott. But we also have a limited time card, but I actually have no idea who it is, so we're gonna have to look after that. For some reason, EA decided last night to not do a legend reveal, which they usually do, so I'm not really too sure why they didn't. But also today, we're going to be getting Madden 19 gameplay. I'm almost positive we're going to be getting a trailer. The EA Play, I believe, starts at 2 p.m. Eastern. So definitely be on the lookout for that. They may release the trailer during that. But definitely you guys do not want to miss out on the Madden 19 trailer and the gameplay, which I'm sure if you do miss out on the EA Play stream, I can imagine within a minute or two, EA themselves will tweet it out. So everyone else can see it, and of course, once they do tweet it out, then I think it's basically for you. So, of course, I'll have a video up on that as soon as they do that. But the new Ultimate Legends we have today, also I made a video on the NFL Mover Solo Challenge rewards, if you guys haven't seen that. Basically allowed me to get a free NFL Mover 98 overall. So make sure you check the video out and see exactly who I picked up. But Franco Harris and Ronnie Lott, I'm also going to be doing a weekly trade-in for these guys. And I also have enough loyalty vouchers to actually get myself an Ultimate Legend fantasy pack. So this is the last fantasy pack, or the last voucher that I'm going to be able to do for the rest of the year. So with that being said, I already did the NAT Golden Ticket Pack and the Ultimate Legend fantasy pack. Now the maximum amount of vouchers you guys could have got would have been 17. So what exactly do you guys think is going to be... It's kind of confusing, but how many do you guys think we're going to be able to use to get an elite player in Madden 19? Now, at the beginning of this year, right, so if you had 10-month loyalty vouchers, you could get a Golden Ticket Fantasy Pack. In my opinion, I'm pretty sure if you guys got 10 vouchers, you're going to be able to get yourself two elite players come Madden 19. Now, this year, to get an elite player, I believe it was 5. Yeah, 5-month loyalty voucher. So if you had enough to get a golden ticket, you should have enough to get a 1 random 82 overall plus elite offensive player and defensive player in Madden 19, which is exactly what I need. In my opinion, those are like the only ones that are worth it. Obviously, you don't want to get silver or gold players. Large tickets, it's whatever if you want to do that, I guess. Small tickets, contracts, course. If you guys didn't know, there are no more contracts in Madden 19, which is huge. So definitely you just want to go with the elite player come Madden 19, whatever it is. Or maybe just some packs, it's up to you guys, but I personally would prefer to get, you know, the elite player. Now in the store right now, the packs that are out are the Legend Fantasy Pack and, of course, the Ultimate Legend Bundle. And then, of course, we have the 9 Movers Bundle and the Movers Night Packs. Now, let me go ahead real quick and check out the Ultimate Legends and see if we can find who the limited time is, because obviously I have no idea who the LTD is for today. And still up to this point, EA has not tweeted a single thing out. So I don't know what they're doing. They're probably extremely busy with the EA Play at this point, which, I mean, I can't blame them. So let's go ahead and see. And so we have Ronnie Lott. It looks like it's Trevor Price as the limited time card today. Not the absolute worst card, but it looks like he's actually going for a little bit cheaper already. So it's 330K. Is he actually cheaper than that? No, he's not. Okay, so Trevor Price, the limited time today, is about 330K. We'll take a look at all those guys' prices after, or their stats, after we get through these packs. So let's get through the Ultimate Legends trade-in pack. What are we going to get? 96 Franco Harris. Okay, that is the best freaking pull you could possibly get. Okay, so let's go ahead and see. Alright, so every single time that I've done this set, I've gotten a 90 overall, 92 overall, something buns, and we just got a 300k pull. Okay, that is awesome. So on the last, or one of the last weeks, we get 200, we basically a 300k pull. That is freaking awesome. Thank you, EA. So finally, doing a weekly trading that actually freaking pays off. Throw him for 290,000 coins, and then we'll get into our Ultimate Legend Fantasy Pack. That was absolutely amazing. Okay. Whew, finally. Okay. I don't know how much luck you guys have had with those packs, but for me personally, I have had the worst pack luck when it comes to those. If you guys have seen all the packs that have opened, I think the best pull I got was like 93. So if you get a 96 of that is definitely amazing. Let's go and get into this Ultimate Legend Fantasy Pack, and we'll see exactly how many coins you're going to make off this. And then, of course, we will get right into the stats of the Ultimate Legends for today. And it looks like round number one is not going to be the absolute best. We'll take these guys, I guess, Marvin Jones. Round number two. Okay, Dante Moncrief, okay. 81 Jared Goff, that is terrible. 90 Franco Harris, okay. And finally, 93 Shannon Sharp. Now, I'm going to guess Shannon Sharp. I feel like he's going to be decently more expensive. 90 Franco Harris, of course, did just come out. But I think the Shannon Sharp is going to go for more. So let me go ahead and check the price on Sharp. And then we'll go ahead and check out the new Ultimate Legends for today. But I really hope that Franco Harris will sell. Honestly, I don't know if it will sell immediately. It'll probably go down a little bit more in price. But still, definitely made a lot of coins off that. So Shannon Sharp, check out his price. And currently going for about 18K. That really sucks. So we'll throw him for 18,000 coins. And then we'll check out Franco. And just make sure we didn't get undercut, which I'm sure we probably did, to be completely honest with you. But 18,000 coins for Shannon Sharp. Also going to have some weekly rewards coming out for you guys very soon. So be on the lookout for that video as well. But Franco Harris is... no. Okay, so yeah, I did get undercut, of course. We'll throw this one up back, I guess, for 275,000 coins. I guess I should do that. And then we'll go ahead and check out the new Ultimate Legends for today. Make sure you guys check out my video from earlier today about, of course, the Movers solo challenges, because it honestly wasn't that bad, to be completely honest with you guys. And the solo challenges take about 2 hours to do. And if you guys have did them already, or you haven't done them already, you probably should go in. Just, some free coins. It takes about 2 hours. And you can basically get, if you don't want to sell everything, probably about, well, off the gold token, you get probably like 120K or something like that. So honestly, still worth it to do. 2 hours make probably about 150,000 coins, to be completely honest with you guys. Or you can complete one of the 98 overall mover sets, because of course you get a bunch of silver tokens as well, which you could probably sell those as well. So you might be looking close to like 200K if you don't want to go ahead and do any of the mover sets. But let's go ahead and take a look at the new Ultimate Legends, as we have Ronnie Lott, which of course has two chems, comparing to Ed Reed, 96 speed, 98 excel, 97 play rec, 94 tackle, 91 man, 97 zone, 97 pursuit, and a 98 hit power. In my opinion, no doubt about it, he's definitely the better card. I mean, literally every single stat is the same or better, except for zone, which doesn't matter after 91. So 97 compared to 98, doesn't matter. Better hit power, man coverage, tackle, acceleration, same player X, same speed, 1 inch taller, strength is 12 better, that's huge, excel is 3 better. Catching, of course, not going to be as high, but still 82 catching is amazing. 97 jumping, I'd imagine the block shift should be higher, block shift an 80 freaking 8, holy crap, this card is insane. And, of course, the 98 hit power you would expect from Ronnie Lott with 99 stamina, this card is wild. Pick 6 chem as well. If you give him physical front, then I guess the card is just unstoppable. It gets 99 hit power, block shouldn't even go to a 92, and then of course I guess you get another chemistry, so you can go with toughness, get the speed, or whatever you guys want to do. Unfortunately, I don't have toughness tier 5, but we also have Franco Tanko Harris, comparing to Christian Okoye, 93 speed, 95 strength, 97 awareness, 88 run blocking, 93 catching, holy crap. 98 carrying, 96 stiff arm, and a 96 trucking. Also has a 97 acceleration and an impact block. Let's see what that impact is. 85. So he's not as good of a run blocker, but he's definitely better in terms of just all around. I mean, the catching is extremely good. And the speed is a little bit better. And, of course, strength is just one better. So, yeah, it's basically pick or choose. Do you want Christian Okoye? Do you want Franco Harris? Do you run the ball more with your fullback? Or do you want someone that can carry it across the goal line? That's all you gotta know. And then finally, we have the limited time card for today, which is Trevor Price, which I'm actually curious to see him exactly how much he's going for, because it looks like he's extremely cheap, and there are a ton of him up. He's currently going for 280,000 coins. That is pretty pathetic. We'll take a look at him compared to Bruce Smith. 84 speed, so he's 3 speed less. 98 strength, he's a little bit stronger. Acceleration to 89, 98 tackle, 99 block shed, 98 power move with 89 finesse and a 98 play rec. The card's honestly pretty good. I don't know why he's going for so cheap. Probably because he doesn't have secure tackler out of the way. He has battle ready chem. The block shed's amazing. Power move's good. Tackling, strength. Obviously, the card is pretty good. But if you guys enjoyed the video, hit the like button, subscribe, and comment. Gonna be having some weekly rewards coming out for you guys today, as well as some Madden 19 news, which I'm sure they will drop, so be on the lookout for that. And as always, I'll see you guys next time.